He has now to explain his withdrawal of support from the written objection to a Senate panel's contempt order against controversial religious leader Apollo Quiboloy, Senator J.V. Ejercito, who is now on Dateline Philippines. Good afternoon, Senator Ejercito.
Yes, good afternoon, Stanley, and good afternoon to our viewers of ANZ.
All right. Why did you withdraw your signature against the contempt order for Pastor Apollo Quiboloy?
Well, first of all, I would like to explain first why I signed in the first place. That was the day that Secretary of Justice Boying Remulla announced that cases will already be filed against Pastor Quiboloy by the DOJ. So that was in the news. So I told myself, for procedural practicality, since the ending the aim of any Senate investigation is, in the end, you will recommend filing of cases. So for practicality, I said that since DOJ will already file, then probably there's no more need for to continue the investigation.
Okay.
So likewise, another factor is the security and order. Factor Stanley, because you know we're this sensitive because we're dealing with a leader, spiritual leader of a group. Then you know there might be blind followers or fanatics that you know might do something. And our security, our Senate security, most of them are already owned.
Okay.
I was also concerned for their safety. But okay. Senator Risa Ontiveros, in the lounge, said that Senator Nancy Binay suggested why not just online, no, for security purposes. She said that can be considered as long as Pastor Quiboloy acknowledges the committee, no. So that these factors made change my mind that I withdrew my signature, and I asked Senator Robin Padilla politely, I gave him the courtesy that I'm withdrawing already.
And how did signature. How did he react to this withdrawal?
He said that, you know, it's my decision, and he understands my decision. So I think he was okay with it, and he understood my reasons for withdrawing.
Okay, you mentioned a lot of conditions there. You had security, also some of the processes there, which initially made you decide to, you know, sign the petition against the contempt order. But now, based on the merits of the case, purely on merits, do you agree with Senator Risa Ontiveros' initial endorsement to the Senate leadership for the arrest order of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy? Of course, we know for a fact that he's been snubbing the hearings.
Well, I think it would be a good chance for, you know, just to put it straight, Stanley, you know, Pastor Quiboloy has done nothing wrong with me. In fact, I acknowledge that we have met quite a few times because being a national candidate, he received us warmly, he was very friendly. So I think this will be a good chance for him also to air his side, because if you would, since because of his non-participation, the hearing seems to be one-sided. So I think it would be a good chance for him to be heard as well and air his side. No? So that's also one reason that, you know, I think it will be good for both sides to be heard. That's why that's also one factor I withdrew.
Yes, Senator Ejercito, what do you make of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy's apprehensions that he might not get a fair treatment during the hearing, and that he has been prejudged and his testimonies will be used to incriminate him further? These are the contents of his statement, which was taken by his lawyer during the hearings this week.
He has nothing to worry, because a lot of our my colleagues acknowledge that he is their friend, no? So there are a lot, I think he will have a lot of, not to say allies, but friends who will make sure that he will be treated fairly in the Senate. I, for one, I as I mentioned earlier, he did nothing wrong to me.
Yeah.
I would want to him to be heard and make sure that he will be treated properly in the Senate, Stanley.
Okay, Senator Ejercito, have you spoken to any of your colleagues or your other colleagues at the Senate? Because, you know, Senator Robin Padilla needs to get 8 signatures to get this done. What sentiments are you gauging from your other companions who have not yet made their decisions?
I really do not know at this point, Stanley, but I have from my own observation, there's still a lot of, I think the remaining lady legislators for sure will not sign anymore, no? Because this is a committee on women, I think that they will not sign. So it will be a very close one, no? If the 7 needed signatures can still be achieved, no? Because considering that there are a lot of women lady legislators in our in this committee, I think the remaining lady legislators who have not signed will not sign anymore.
Okay, lastly, what do you say to some opinions that this is highly politicized and that some senators are just playing safe because of the fast approaching 2025 elections?
Well, actually, Stanley, I think it's more of, it's no secret that we are having our conflict with the House because of the PI. The congressmen have been on air, having press conference, daily press conference, hitting the Senate. So we have to always take care of this issue as well. And likewise, just recently, I'm sure you heard about the threat to the Senate leadership. So sadly, we were as part of the majority and deputy majority. I had to be with my, I had to protect my Senate president, Ming Subiri, because I don't think there is a compelling reason for him to be replaced. So we were busy meeting senators individually, in groups, by twos. So that was in the past 2 weeks, that took our most of our time. I think it's the timing, no? That the hearings of on Pastor Kubiloy happened simultaneously with this threat to the Senate leadership.
All right. Lastly, again, if you had a chance to talk to Pastor Kubiloy, what's your message? What would you like to tell him?
Well, to Pastor Kubiloy, he's been very accommodating, very warm. Wala akong naging kasalanan sa akin. Ang sa akin, we will make sure that sisiguraduhin natin na kayo tatatoy na maayos sa Senado kasi marami naman hong kayo kaibigan sa Senado, no? At yan po yung inamin naman po ng ating mga kasamahan. And okay, for one, you did nothing wrong to me, and I'll make sure that you will be treated properly, and I'm hoping that you'll be able to hear, people will be able to hear your side, no? Kasi para naman hindi one-sided, because I think one of the reasons that I signed para po marinig naman yung panig nyo. That's all, Stanley. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much, Senator J.V. Ejercito. Thank you.
Thank you.